next and last topic of this chapter, that is consequences of some natural consequences of total internal reflection. So for this one, you refer to your textbook. All right, one by one, the way it is given in the textbook, I am just discussing that way. So that's why I am not writing the statement on the whiteboard. I am just saying it. Now we are having this experience, especially because we are staying in Dhanbad, which is very hot in during summer. Now you see that when you are in a long drive during summer days, then if you look, a long path is in front of you. You are sitting on your car and a long path is in front of you. Then you must, sometimes you must observe that as if there is a pool of water in front of you. Okay, while running, while moving, you will observe that as if a pool of water is on the road. You are observing that. But by the time your car reaches that point, you will see nothing is there. No water is there. All right. So this is this illusion, this one, this phenomena, it is known as mirage. All right. So let us try to find out why it is happening. Clear? So before that, you have to know that in case of total internal reflection, as the entire incident light gets reflected, so the point at which the light reflects, that point shines very high. Okay, it shines like a mirror. Nothing is there, but it will shine like a mirror. So here you see what is happening. So on a summer day, so if you consider, this is the earth surface. All right, so as it is the earth surface, it is very hot. So what will happen if you consider the different layer of air above the earth surface, then lower part, they are very hot. So as they are hot, what will happen? Temperature very high, so density will be less. So if I draw the diagram, then you see here the density decreases in the downward direction. Means the lower layers, they are the rarer medium, then higher one is denser medium. Is that clear? Now suppose here is the sun. Clear? You don't have to draw the diagram. You need the understanding. So you understand it. So sunlight, when it is entering into the atmosphere, it is moving from denser to, it is denser, it is rarer. Alright. So what will happen? It will bend away from the normal. Then again when it is falling, then you see angle of incidence increases. So it is bending away from the normal. Again it is bending away from the normal. So again it is bending away from the normal. Alright. So it may happen that when it is falling here, angle of incidence is such that it is suffering total internal reflection. It is greater than the critical angle between the two successive layers. So what will happen? This light, when it will be received by you, this point will appear as a mirror. Means as if there is a pool of water, light ray is falling on it and it is appearing like a mirror. Okay. So that is the cause that when, while driving through a long path during summer day, it appears that there is a pool of water in front of you, but there is actually nothing is there. So how you will write down the answer? You will write down the answer. This happens due to atmospheric refraction and total internal reflection. Alright, what are the two terms you have to write? It happens due to atmospheric refraction and total internal reflection of light. The next consequence is an empty test tube, if you keep inside a beaker which is full of water. Alright, then you will see at a particular angle, if you look at the test tube, the test tube will shine like a mirror. So what is happening? You see here, when the light is moving from water, then it is entering to glass. Then from the glass, when it is trying to enter into the air within the test tube. Within the test tube, what is there? Air is there. So you write it down. This is air and this is glass. Okay. Now, if the angle of incidence is such that it is greater than the critical angle of glass-air interface. Alright. So here you just write it down. Here angle of incidence is greater than critical angle. So what will happen? Light will not enter into air. Rather it will suffer total internal reflection. So when this totally internally reflected light will be received by the observer eye, then this point, the point of incidence here, it will appear like a shining mirror. Alright, so this is the cause. So how you can handle the answer of this question? You just draw this diagram and then write down the answer. It happens due to total internal reflection at the glass air interface as shown in the diagram. I repeat, how to write in statement? It happens due to total internal reflection at glass air interface. You must mention it. Glass air interface as shown in the diagram. Now next is, suppose there is a crack. The crack is actually not so big. Alright. I have drawn it big so that you can understand it. So suppose there is a crack on a glass piece. Then you will, if you look at the crack, sometimes from a certain angle, you just understand, from a certain angle only it appears very bright like a shining mirror. Okay, why it is so? So crack means what? Within the crack. So crack actually it is very small. Again I am saying, I have drawn it big. So within the crack, what is there? Air. So you see, when the light ray is moving from, trying to enter into the crack, it is moving from glass to air. Then if it happens that angle of incidence is greater than critical angle, then the light ray, instead of entering into the crack, it will suffer total internal reflection and it will be received by the observer eye. So when the observer eye will receive this totally internally reflected light, then this point will appear shining. Alright, that's why crack in a glass, it appears shining when it is observed from a certain angle. So how to write the answer of this third consequence? You draw this diagram as I have drawn. It is glass, it is air, and you don't forget to write that I greater than IC. And then in sentence, what you will write? I hope you can write it yourself now. What to write? You have to write that it happens due to total internal reflection at the glass air interface as shown in the diagram. The next consequence is very interesting. We know that diamond, it sparkles. That's why we ladies, we all women, we love it very much, no? So why diamond sparkle? Physics is behind it. Okay, so let us find it out. If you consider diamond, then for diamond, these are the points you have to write. For diamond, refractive index is very high. Alright? Refractive index of diamond. I have written only mu, but when you write the answer, what you will write? You must write refractive index of diamond is very high. So if refractive index is very high, then what will happen to the critical angle? Critical angle is very low. Alright. So as the critical angle is very low, then what will happen to the diamond? And you know that diamond, a special kind of cut is generally given to it. So I am just trying to draw one cut. So suppose this is one cut of diamond. Alright, now what will happen? Just see, when light ray is entering into it, then the angle of incidence, whatever it is, critical angle as it is very low, so probability of total internal reflection is very high. So what will happen? You see, the light will enter, it will suffer total internal reflection. So you see, when it will suffer total internal reflection, it will shine. Is that clear? Now it is falling here. It is suffering total internal reflection. So this point will shine. Then it is falling here. It is suffering total internal reflection. So this will also shine. Then again total internal reflection. Again total internal reflection. So this way it will go on reflecting within the diamond. And at every point it is suffering reflection, total internal reflection. That point will appear very bright. It will shine like a mirror. Alright, and here in case of total internal reflection, as no light is absorbed by the reflecting surface, so it will suffer several total internal reflection within the diamond piece and it will remain entrapped within it. So what is happening? That the diamond is sparkle, the diamond sparkles, or the diamond brilliance of diamond takes place. Alright, so how to write down the answer? First of all, you write down that refractive index of diamond is very high. Second, you will write down critical angle is very low. So write it down that probability of, or chances also, probability you cannot write, you can write chances. Chances of total internal reflection is very high. So then what you will write, I am not writing, it will take time. I am just saying you please listen and write it down. The next point, what you will write down, as light enters into the diamond piece, it suffers several total internal reflection. What you will write? It suffers several total internal reflection. And then next point you will write, as a result, diamond sparkles. Alright. So, why does a diamond sparkle? How to write down the answer? These are the points. First point, refractive index of diamond is high. Second point, critical angle is very low. Third point, probability or chances of total internal reflection is very high. Then next point, what you will write? As light enters into the diamond piece, it suffers several total internal reflection. Then next point you will write, as a result, diamond sparkles. Now, although it is the last topic, but very important topic. Now, optical fiber is used to transmit light through a long distance. Alright. Just the examples of optical fibers are that in communication system, optical fiber is used. And you know that whenever the complicated operations are going on and you want to take, doctors want to take the image of the internal organ, then light has to, doctor has to send light within the body, isn't it? So how the light is sent? Light is sent through the optical fiber. Alright. So you can just consider optical fiber is just like a water pipe. Through the water pipe, we send water through a long distance. Clear? Now, through the optical fiber, we send light through a long distance. Now, the question will arise that why we are not sending the light? Because light, we can just, you have said that you just focus a torch, the light can move. But why we need optical fiber? Because when you are focusing a torch, then by focusing a torch, you cannot send light through a long distance. Why? Light is getting spread, light does spread in all direction. Alright, it gets absorbed by the medium through which it is passing. So that's why, while we want to send light through a long distance, we use a optical fiber. Alright, now what is a optical fiber? So as I said, just you imagine, you know that in science imagination is needed. Water pipe, how the water pipe is made? There is a plastic coating, isn't it? And the plastic, so just you consider this. This is a plastic coating and here it is hollow, air is there. Alright, that is the water pipe. So optical fiber is like this. Yes, you see, just look at the diagram, one piece of optical fiber I have drawn. So, in case of water pipe, this is made up of plastic. Now, in case of optical fiber, this outer coat, it is made up of one material known as cladding. Alright. And in case of water pipe, inside air is there. And in case of optical fiber, inside, it is not air or vacuum. It is coat is there. Alright. And optical fiber, the diagram I have drawn, it is so big. But, you know, the original thickness of optical fiber, it is just like the few strands of your hair. Alright, so you can easily imagine what, how much thin our optical fiber is. Clear? So first point, from the point of view of exam, you have to know, right, what is optical fiber. So what is optical fiber? It is a device which is used to transmit light through a long distance. Alright, or you can write down, so first point you must note down in your study material notebook is, what is optical fiber? So what is optical fiber? Optical fiber is a device which is used in transmission of light through a long distance. Alright. Transmission of light should be underlined and through a long distance should be underlined. Now, this is the original structure of the optical fiber. Alright. As I said, the outer layer, this is also cladding, I have not written. And inner one is coat. Now you see what is happening when light enters into it. Clear? Now here, coat is denser than cladding. What I said? Coat is denser than cladding. So light, when it will enter into the optical fiber, it will try to move from coat to cladding. Means trying to move from denser to rarer medium. Now in this case also, critical angle, as it is small, so what will happen? Light ray will suffer total internal reflection. Will come here. Then again it will suffer total internal reflection. Come here. Again it will suffer total internal reflection. So you see, this is the way it is go on suffering. several total internal reflection, and you can transmit it through a long distance. Again, another point here, that during the total internal reflection, what is happening? No light is absorbed, entire light is transmitted. So what will happen when you are transmitting light through the optical fiber, then intensity of light never get reduced. Clear? So that's why we use optical fiber. So what is the probable question from it? How the optical fiber works, or what is the principle of working of optical fiber? What will be your answer? Please note down the answer. I am not writing it on the board. Answer will be, optical fiber works on the principle of several total internal reflection and refraction. Alright, or you may get the question, how light gets transmitted through the optical fiber? You should write down by several. So the this one keywords are several total internal reflection and refraction. Refraction will take place at the beginning and at the end, and in between what will happen? Several total internal reflection. So the two probable question from the last topic I'm discussing, what is optical fiber and how does it work, or what is the name of the principle or phenomena associated with optical fiber? So what will write? What is the phenomena? Total internal reflection. And if it comes that how does it work, then you will write down, light suffers several total internal, several or multiple, you can use the term, that is a better term I think, multiple total internal reflection. Okay, so that's all about the refraction at plane surfaces. So girls, please write down all the important points I discussed in the last lectures properly in the notebook, study material notebook, and also draw the numerical, draw the ray diagrams, that the six ray diagrams and all the important ray diagrams in the numerical notebook, and also the numerical numericals I sent through PDF file, that also you please clearly note down. So we completed today four chapters. So please everybody finish your work, then I will take one test on these four chapters. Thank you, children.